हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज मोहम्मद जलील अहमद, लेक्चरर इन केमिस्ट्री, डॉक्टर बीआरआर गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज जड़चेरला। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ अल्कोहल्स। Among the physical properties of alcohols, physical state. Aliphatic alcohols and lower aromatic alcohols exist in liquid state at room temperature, whereas highly branched alcohols and alcohols with or more carbon atoms exist in solid state. Boiling points. Boiling points of alcohols are higher than corresponding alkanes and chloroalkanes of similar relative molecular mass. Why the question arises, why boiling points of alcohols are higher than corresponding alkanes and chloroalkanes? It is because in alcohol molecules are held by hydrogen bonds. Intermolecular hydrogen bonds exist between molecules of alcohol. Due to the presence of intermolecular hydrogen bonds, alcohols possess higher boiling points, whereas intermolecular hydrogen bonds do not exist between the molecules of alkanes and chloroalkanes. Therefore, their boiling points are comparatively very lower. For example, ethyl alcohol, the boiling point of ethyl alcohol is 78 degrees centigrade, whereas the boiling point of propane is minus 42 degrees centigrade. The boiling point of methyl chloride is minus 24 degrees centigrade. When we compare the boiling point of ethyl alcohol with the boiling points of propane and chloromethane, the boiling point of ethyl alcohol is far higher. It is because of the presence of intermolecular hydrogen bonds. So intermolecular hydrogen bonds are responsible for the higher boiling point of alcohols. Reason is also mentioned. Intermolecular hydrogen bonds exist between alcohol molecules. Next, solubility of alcohols in water. Alcohol is miscible in water in all proportions. In general, we say alcohols are miscible with water in all proportions. Alcohols with short carbon chains, that is methanol, ethanol, dissolve in water. Alcohols with short carbon chains dissolve in water. They dissolve in water due to the formation of hydrogen bonds. The question arises, why alcohols are miscible with water in all proportions? Why methanol and ethanol dissolve in water easily? Because methanol or ethanol molecules form hydrogen bonds with water molecules. Due to the formation of intermolecular hydrogen bonds, alcohols are miscible with water in all proportions. The solubility of alcohols decreases sharply with the increasing length of the carbon chain. Solubility of alcohols decreases sharply with the increasing of carbon chain. Means from, if you take from methyl alcohol and ethyl alcohol, the solubility of methyl alcohol is more than that of ethyl alcohol. Similarly, the solubility of ethyl alcohol is more than that of propyl alcohol and butyl alcohol and so on. As the molecular weight of alcohols increases, the solubility of alcohols decreases. Higher alcohols are insoluble in water. Alcohol contains a polar end called hydrophilic end. and a non-polar end, the alkyl group called hydrophobic end. Polyhydroxy alcohols are more soluble than monohydroxy alcohols. Polyhydroxy alcohols are more soluble than monohydroxy alcohols. These polyhydroxy alcohols form more hydrogen bonds with water molecule. Reason also given why polyhydroxy alcohols. Example, glycerol. Glycerol is a polyhydroxy alcohol. Glycerol is more soluble than methanol. It is because glycerol forms more hydrogen bonds with water molecules. Branched hydrocarbon increases the solubility of alcohol in water. Branched hydrocarbon increases the solubility of alcohol in water. Branched hydrocarbon cause the hydrophobic region becomes compact. Now let us discuss the acidity of alcohols and phenols. But our topic is confined to alcohols only, so let us discuss only the acidity of alcohols. Alcohols are weakly acidic. In aqueous solution, alcohol will donate its proton to water molecule to give an alkoxide ion. Alcohol contains a proton. Like all acids donate protons. For example, HCl. HCl donates a proton when it reacts with H2O. Like HCl donates a, has a capacity to donate a proton to H2O. Here ROH means alcohol can also donate a proton to H2O and form alkoxide ion and hydronium ion. Ka value of alcohol is 10 to the power of minus 16 to 10 to the power of minus 18. Example, ethyl alcohol CH3CH2OH plus H2O gives rise to CH3CH2O minus plus H3O plus, that is hydronium ion. The acid dissociation constant Ka of an alcohol is defined by the equilibrium. ROH plus H2O gives rise to RO minus plus H3O plus. Ka is equal to concentration of hydronium ion into concentration of alkoxide ion by concentration of alcohol. Pa is equal to minus logarithm of Ka. More smaller the pKa value, the alcohol is more acidic. Since the pKa value is very small in case of alcohol, alcohol is more acidic. The acidity decreases as the substitution on the alkyl group increases. The acidity decreases as the substitution on the alkyl group increases. Ethyl group is an electron donating group. Ethyl group is an electron donating group. It strengthens the OH bond, harder to release the proton. If ethyl group is present, then it strengthens the OH bond. When OH bond is strengthened by the presence of ethyl group, releasing of proton becomes difficult. That is, methanol is more acidic than tertiary butyl alcohol. Methanol is more acidic than tertiary butyl alcohol. Why? Because in methanol, only one alkyl group is present, whereas in tertiary butyl alcohol, three alkyl groups are present. As the number of alkyl groups increases, the acidity decreases. Therefore, methanol is more acidic than tertiary butyl alcohol. The presence of electron withdrawing atoms enhances the acidity of alcohols. It's a statement. The presence of electron withdrawing group enhances the acidity of alcohols. The electron withdrawing atom helps to stabilize the alkoxide ion. Two example, 2-chloroethanol 2-chloroethanol is more acidic than ethanol. Why 2-chloroethanol is more acidic than ethanol? It is because the electron withdrawing chlorine atom helps to stabilize the 2-chloroethoxyanion. The difference between ethanol and 2-chloroethanol is that 2-chloroethanol is having electron withdrawing Cl atom. This electron withdrawing atom helps to stabilize the alkoxide ion so that releasing a proton becomes easy. So whenever electron withdrawing group is sent, it increases the acidity of alcohol. Alcohol with more than one electron withdrawing atoms are more acidic. It means as the number of electron withdrawing atoms increases in an alcohol, the acidity also increases proportionately. That is 2,2-dichloroethanol. 2,2-dichloroethanol is more acidic than 2-chloroethanol. Why? Because 2,2-dichloroethanol is having two electron withdrawing chlorine atoms, whereas 2-chloroethanol is having only one electron withdrawing chlorine atom. So as the number of electron withdrawing atoms increases, the acidity also increases. 2,2-dichloroethanol is more acidic than 2-chloroethanol, which is more acidic than ethanol. Example of electron withdrawing atoms are groups halogen atoms and NO2. Halogen atoms, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, these are halogen atoms, but fluorine is extremely reactive, therefore leaving fluorine, Cl, Br, I atoms may be considered. Similarly, NO2 is also electron withdrawing group. Now, reactions of alcohols. Reactions of alcohols means it is understood chemical properties of alcohols. Reaction with sodium, oxidation, esterification, halogenation and haloform reactions, dehydration, formation of ether, Williamson synthesis. Reaction with sodium. As far as chemical properties are concerned, alcohols, previously we discussed that alcohols possess acidity. Alcohols are acidic in nature. They behave as weak acids. So all acids react with active metals liberating hydrogen gas. Like acids react with active metals liberating hydrogen gas, alcohols also react with active metals like sodium liberating hydrogen gas. Alcohols react with Na at room temperature to form salts, sodium alkoxides and hydrogen. 2ROH plus 2Na gives rise to 2RONa, 2RO minus Na plus H2. This reaction shows the acidity of alcohols. For example, ethyl alcohol reacts with sodium forming sodium ethoxide liberating hydrogen gas. Reactivity of alcohols towards the reactions with sodium. Reactivity of alcohols towards the reaction with sodium decreases in this order. Methyl group is more reactive than primary alcohol, which is more reactive than secondary alcohol, which is more reactive than tertiary alcohol. Now, oxidation of alcohols. Oxidation means removal of hydrogen atoms or addition of oxygen atoms. In general, removal of hydrogen atoms or addition of oxygen atoms is called oxidation. Primary alcohol, the products of oxidation of alcohols depend on the nature of alcohol. Primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols upon oxidation give different products. Usually primary alcohols upon oxidation gives aldehyde. those aldehydes are further oxidized to carboxylic acids. For example, if you take ethyl alcohol upon oxidation with acidified potassium dichromate or alkaline potassium permanganate gives acetaldehyde. This acetaldehyde is further oxidized to give acetic acid. So usually primary alcohols upon oxidation give aldehydes which are further oxidized to carboxylic acids. In order to stop the oxidation reaction at the aldehyde stage, mild oxidizing agents are used. Acidified potassium dichromate or alkaline potassium permanganate are strong oxidizing agents, whereas pyridium chlorochromate, PCC, pyridium chlorochromate is a mild oxidizing agent. So pyridium chlorochromate in the presence of dichloromethane will act as a mild oxidizing agent. Whenever a primary alcohol is oxidized by pyridium chlorochromate gives an aldehyde. Primary alcohol on treating with the copper or chromium trioxide in the presence of pyridine gives aldehyde. In this reaction, primary alcohol is converted to aldehyde. Primary alcohol is converted to aldehyde. Here, in this reaction, removal of hydrogen atoms takes place. Two hydrogen atoms have been removed from primary alcohol. So this reaction occurs in the presence of copper or CrO3 in the presence of pyridine. So primary alcohol upon oxidation gives aldehyde. Similarly, primary alcohol on treating with the acidified KMnO4 or acidified K2Cr2O7 or acidified CrO3 gives a carboxylic acid. Previously I told you acidified KMnO4 is a strong oxidizing agent. Acidified K2Cr2O7 is also a strong oxidizing agent. Acidified CrO3 is also a strong oxidizing agent. In the presence of strong oxidizing agents like acidified KMnO4 or acidified K2Cr2O7, primary alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde, which is further oxidized to carboxylic acid. So vigorous oxidation occurs. That's why to stop the oxidation of a primary alcohol at aldehyde stage, mild oxidizing agents are used. Otherwise, primary alcohols undergo oxidation to give aldehyde, which is further oxidized to give carboxylic acid. Examples: 1-hexanol. 1-hexanol. 1-hexanol is a primary alcohol. In the presence of mild oxidizing agent PCC, that is pyridium chlorochromate, 1-hexanol is oxidized to hexanol, means a primary alcohol is oxidized to an aldehyde. Here the oxidation process of primary alcohol stops at the aldehyde stage. If you observe the second example, all oxidation of 1-hexanol. Oxidation of 1-hexanol gives hexanoic acid. Here oxidation of 1-hexanol takes place in the presence of acidified potassium permanganate or acidified potassium dichromate or acidified chromium trioxide. Since acidified KMnO4 or acidified K2Cr2O7 or acidified CrO3 are powerful oxidizing agents, strong oxidizing agents, This primary alcohol is initially oxidized to an aldehyde, which is further oxidized to a carboxylic acid. So, 1-hexanol is ultimately oxidized to give hexanoic acid. So, what is the conclusion in this one? Primary alcohols upon oxidation with mild oxidizing agents like PCC give an aldehyde, whereas primary alcohols upon oxidation with the strong oxidizing agents give carboxylic acids. Secondary alcohols upon oxidation give ketone. Secondary alcohol upon oxidation give ketone. Like primary alcohol upon oxidation give an aldehyde, similarly, secondary alcohol upon oxidation give a ketone. Here secondary alcohol is given RRCHOH, which is oxidized to RCOR ketone, esterified K-4 or esterified K2CR2O7 or esterified CRO3 are taken as oxidizing agents. Now come to the oxidation of tertiary alcohol. A tertiary alcohol is not oxidized with acidified potassium permanganate or acidified potassium dichromate or acidified chromium trioxide, because here tertiary alcohols three alkyl groups are found and the oxidizing power decreases from primary alcohol to tertiary alcohol. Primary alcohols are readily oxidized, whereas secondary alcohols are also oxidized, but tertiary alcohols do not undergo oxidation in the presence of strong oxidizing agents like acidified K-4 or K2CR2O7. Example, 2-butanol. 2-butanol upon oxidation with the acidified K-4 and acidified K2CR2O7 give 2-butanone. This is the best example for the oxidation of secondary alcohol. Secondary alcohol upon oxidation give a ketone. 2-butanol is oxidized to 2-butanone. Now esterification. What is meant by esterification? Ester means the product which is formed when a carboxylic acid reacts with an alcohol in the presence of a mineral acid. Whenever any carboxylic acid reacts with an alcohol in the presence of a mineral acid like H2SO4 gives an ester. So formation of an ester is called esterification. We can say that carboxylic acid plus alcohol gives rise to ester plus water. Here example for esterification: when ethanol is treated with ethanoic acid, means when ethyl alcohol is treated with acetic acid in the presence of H2SO4 gives ethyl ethanoate. Ethyl ethanoate means here it is ethyl acetate. Ethyl acetate is formed, which is also called ethyl ethanoate. One more example is given for the formation of an ester. Methanol reacts with benzoic acid in the presence of a mineral acid gives methyl benzoate, which is also an ester. So esters are used in making perfumes. Ester is a product formed when a carboxylic acid reacts with an alcohol in the presence of a mineral acid. Esterification also occurs when alcohols react with the derivatives of carboxylic acids such as acid chlorides. Esterification also occurs when alcohols react with the derivatives of carboxylic acids such as chlorides. In the previous example, what we studied, alcohol plus carboxylic acid gives rise to an ester. But formation of ester is also possible when an alcohol is treated with acid chloride. For that reaction, one example we can see, methanol is an alcohol. This methanol reacts with ethanoyl chloride, that is acetyl chloride. When methyl alcohol reacts with acetyl chloride, gives methyl ethanoate. So esterification is also possible with an alcohol and acid chloride. So when an alcohol reacts with an acid chloride, also gives an ester. Now, halogenation and haloform reactions. Halogenation and haloform reactions. Hydrogen halides, HBr or HCl or HI. Halogenation means the replacement of hydrogen atom of a molecule by halogen atom. Here, alcohols undergo halogenation reactant to give alkyl halide. ROH plus HX gives rise to RX plus H2O. Example, when ethyl alcohol is treated with hydrogen bromide, gives ethyl bromide and water. So for halogenation purpose, we can take a halogenating agent as HBr or HCl or HI. The reactivity also decreases. The reactivity decreases from HI to HCl. Hydrogen iodide is more reactive than hydrogen bromide, which is more reactive than hydrogen chloride. So for halogenation reaction, the reactivity of hydrogen halides decreases from hydrogen iodide to hydrogen chloride. And reactivity of alcohols also decrease. Reactivity of alcohols also decreases from tertiary to primary. Tertiary alcohols readily undergo halogenation, whereas primary alcohols undergo halogenation with great difficulty. So tertiary alcohols undergo halogenation more easily than a primary alcohol. Now, reaction with the phosphorus trihalides. Phosphorus trihalides PX3 or phosphorus pentahalides PX5. PX3 or PX5, these are halogenating agents. X may be Cl, Br or I. So when an alcohol reacts with the halogenating agents like PX3 or PX5, form alkyl halides. So alkyl halides can also be prepared by treating alcohols with halogenating agents like PX3 or PX5, phosphorus trihalide or phosphorus pentahalide. Example, isobutyl alcohol. Isobutyl alcohol reacts with phosphorus tribromide to give isobutyl bromide. Thionyl chloride is also a chlorinating agent. SOCl2 is also halogenating agent, that is chlorinating agent. Instead of PCl3 or PCl5, we may also take thionyl chloride. So alcohol reacts with thionyl chloride to give alkyl halide. ROH plus SOCl2 gives rise to RCl plus SO2 plus HCl. Example, 1-heptanol. 1-heptanol reacts with thionyl chloride to give 1-chloroheptane, SO2 and HCl. In this reaction, alcohol is converted to alkyl halide. So alkyl halides can also be prepared by treating alcohol with the thionyl chloride. Dehydration, removal of water. Dehydration means removal of water. Dehydration of alcohols will form alkenes, and the products will follow Sedjef rule. Here, dehydration of alcohol gives an alkene. RCH2CH2OH gives rise to RCH double bond CH2 plus H2O. Here, concentrated H2SO4 acts as a dehydrating agent. In the presence of concentrated H2SO4, an alcohol undergoes dehydration to give an alkene. Here, said Jeff Rulis, followed. A reaction that produces an alkene would favor the formation of an alkene that has the greatest number of substituents attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. One example is given here, 2-butanol. When 2-butanol undergoes dehydration in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, gives 1-butene and 2-butene, two possible products are there, 1-butene and 2-butene. Here, removal of water molecule takes place. Water molecule may be removed. Here, OH group, hydrogen atom of methyl group may combine with OH, giving rise to 1-butene. Hydrogen atom of CH3CH2. The hydrogen atom of CH2 combines with OH and is removed in the form of H2O, then 2-butene will be formed. Two possibilities are there. 2-butanol undergoes hydration, giving rise to two possible products. They are 1-butene, 2-butene. But here, according to Sir Jeff Rule, 2-butene will be the major product. Why? Because in 2-butene, the carbon-carbon double bond is accompanied by two alkyl groups, whereas in 1-butene, carbon-carbon double bond is accompanied by only one alkyl group. So whenever an alkene, according to Sir Jeff Rule, an alkene containing more number of alkyl groups attached with carbon-carbon double bond is formed. So 2-butene will be the major product according to Sir Jeff Rule. Reactivity of alcohols towards dehydration. Reactivity of alcohols decreases from tertiary to primary. Tertiary alcohols easily undergo dehydration than secondary as well as primary alcohols. Reagents for dehydration. Already I told you, concentrated sulfuric acid is a strong dehydrating agent. Ethyl alcohol upon dehydration in the presence of concentrated H2SO4 gives ethene. So ethyl alcohol on dehydration gives ethene. Similarly, cyclohexanol upon dehydration gives cyclohexene. Names are not mentioned, only structures are mentioned. So cyclohexanol upon dehydration in the presence of phosphoric acid H3PO4 gives cyclohexene. Vapor phase dehydration of alcohols. Ethyl alcohol upon dehydration in the presence of anhydrous Al2O3 gives ethene. So dehydration of ethyl alcohol also occurs in the presence of Al2O3, aluminum. Formation of ether, Williamson's synthesis. Formation of ether, Williamson's synthesis. So Williamson's synthesis is one of the best methods to prepare ethers. Then the question arises, what is Williamson's synthesis? When an alkoxide reacts with an alkyl halide, gives an ether. This reaction is called Williamson's synthesis. In order to prepare an alkoxide, we must take an alcohol. An alcohol on treating with the active metal like sodium gives an alkoxide. That an alkoxide reacts with an alkyl halide, giving rise to an ether. Formation of ether involves the SN2 attack of an alkoxide ion on unhindered primary alkyl halides. As you know, primary alkyl halides undergo SN2 reaction mechanism. So the alkoxide is made by adding NaK or NaI, NaH to the alcohol. The alkoxide is made by adding NaKRNaH to the alcohol. Already I told you, whenever an alcohol is treated with sodium metal or potassium metal or sodium hydride, giving rise to an alkoxide. That alkoxide reacts with alkyl halide, giving rise to ether. The alkyl halides must be primary so that a backside attack is not hindered. If suppose tertiary alkyl halide is taken, then backside attack is not possible because the backside attack of alkyl group is hindered by three alkyl groups present in tertiary alcohol, that's tertiary alkyl halide. That's why the alkyl halides must be a primary alkyl halide so that backside attack may not be hindered. If the alkyl halide is not primary, elimination usually occurs to form alkenes. If the alkyl halide is not a primary alkyl halide, elimination reaction occurs. When elimination reaction occurs, it leads to the formation of an alkene. Examples are given. Ethyl alcohol reacts with sodium metal, gives rise to sodium ethoxide and methyl iodide. This sodium ethoxide on treating with an alkyl halide, giving rise to methyl ethyl ether or ethyl methyl ether. Alphabetical order must be followed. So since E comes before M, ethyl methyl ether is formed. Here one example is given. Ethanol on treating with the sodium metal. Ethanol on treating with the sodium metal and methyl iodide gives ethyl methyl ether. Here it is understood ethanol reacts with sodium metal giving rise to sodium ethoxide. That sodium ethoxide further reacts with methyl iodide giving rise to methyl ethyl methyl ether. Cyclohexanol on treating with sodium metal and also CH3CH2OTS, giving rise to ethoxychlorohexane. In this reaction also, hexanol, it seems like that hexanol is directly converted to ethoxycyclohexane, that is also ether. So whenever an alcohol is treated with active metal like sodium and an alkyl halide, this alcohol will be converted to an ether. This reaction is known as Williamson synthesis. Test to distinguish classes of alcohols. Lucas test. In Lucas test, we use Lucas reagent. What is Lucas reagent? Mixture of zinc chloride and concentrated hydrochloric acid is called Lucas reagent. So in order to identify whether the given alcohol is primary alcohol or secondary alcohol or tertiary alcohol, we can take Lucas test. Lucas test is useful to identify the alcohols. In this Lucas test, the given alcohol is shaken with Lucas reagent. That is solution of zinc chloride in concentrated HCl. When an alcohol is mixed with or shaken with Lucas reagent, if immediately turbidity appears, then it is tertiary alcohol. If turbidity appears after some time, after 5 minutes, then it is secondary alcohol. If no turbidity appears, then it is primary alcohol. It means if turbidity means cloudiness, when an alcohol is shaken with Lucas reagent, if cloudiness appears immediately due to the formation of alkyl chloride, then we can say that the given alcohol is tertiary alcohol. If cloudiness appears after 5 minutes, then the given alcohol is a secondary alcohol. If cloudiness did not appear after a long time, we can say that the given alcohol is said to be primary alcohol. see the reactions going on. In tertiary alcohol, this is tertiary butyl alcohol. When tertiary butyl alcohol is treated with Lucas reagent, gives tertiary butyl chloride. Cloudy solution almost immediately. When Lucas reagent is added to tertiary butyl alcohol, within no time, tertiary butyl chloride forms. We can say that this is a tertiary alcohol. Secondary alcohol. When the secondary alcohol is treated with Lucas reagent, cloudy solution will be formed within 5 minutes. Cloudy solution will be formed within 5 minutes. Means formation of alkyl halide occurs after 5 minutes. Means within 5 minutes, formation of alkyl halide occurs. Here, when Lucas reagent is added to this primary alcohol, that is 1-butanol or N-butanol, when Lucas reagent is added to N-butanol, no reaction occurs. When no reaction occurs, it is understood this is a primary alcohol. Oxidation of alcohols. Only primary and secondary alcohols are oxidized by hot esterified K-4 or hot esterified K2CO7 solution. The alcohol is heated with K-4 or K2CO7 in the presence of dilute H2SO4, primary or secondary. The purple color of K-4 solution, disappears. The color of the K2CO7 solution changes from orange to green. Tertiary alcohol does not react with K-4 or K2CO7. See, we are discussing the test to identify alcohols, no? So alcohols can be identified by Lucas test. One more test is there to identify alcohols, that is oxidation process. By oxidation process, alcohols may be tested. So in this oxidation process, strong oxidizing agents may be used. Esterified K2CO7, esterified K-4 may be used. If purple color of K-4 solution disappears, we can say that is primary alcohol. If color of the K2CO7 solution changes from orange to green, we can say that is secondary alcohol. And there will be no change in case of K-4 and K2CO7. It means that tertiary alcohol does not react with either K-4 or K2CO7. Reactions are also mentioned here. Primary alcohol reacts with the dichromate ion in the presence of acid, gives an aldehyde, reducing chromium ion. Aldehyde, when reacts with the potassium dichromate, gives carboxylic acid, producing chromium ion. Secondary alcohol in the presence of dichromate and acid gives ketone. Haloform test to identify methyl alcohol group. Iodoform. Ethanol and secondary alcohols containing the group methyl alcohol group, which react with alkaline solutions of iodine to form triiodomethane. Iodoform, CHI3. Triiodomethane is a pale yellow solid with a characteristic smell. Here, formation of yellow precipitate of triiodomethane occurs. The iodoform test can distinguish ethanol from methanol. Ethanol reacts with iodine in alkaline medium form iodoform, whereas methanol does not form iodoform. So using iodoform test, we can identify ethanol from methanol, because ethanol only form iodoform, whereas methanol cannot form iodoform. The iodoform test can distinguish 2-propanol from 1-propanol. 2-propanol forms iodoform, 1-propanol does not form iodoform. It means iodoform test is positive for 2-propanol, whereas it is negative for 1-propanol. Tertiary alcohols do not give positive iodoform test. थैंक यू।